reabsorb, and then it becomes filled with fluid, and then they call it a cyst. Right? So they say you have a cyst in your ovary, it's a fluid filled bag. Why? Because you have too much of that chemical, you have too much of these follicles getting thin, and your body can't get rid of it, so it envelops it, and then what happens? It's filled with fluid. But if you understand your menstrual cycle as a woman, it will give you a greater understanding of even the symptoms that you get when you have polycystic ovarian syndrome. You understanding me? Alright, so with science class in. Normally they just make science difficult. I'm making it very easy for you. A difficult thing I need to do, guys. That's why you never learn it, because you were afraid of science. But it's not difficult, it's very easy. And it's your body. And you want to know, and you need to know. Right? Yeah. Okay, alright. Now, what is this effort? Let's go. Vagina. Come on, man. Come on. The man, you can say it to you. Vagina. Right. What's that called? The cervix. And what's this? What's this? Ovaries. Okay, now that's the fallopian tube, and I can't mention that. That's the fallopian tube. Okay, alright. Now, this is what you call the menstrual cycle. What happens during the menstrual cycle? And the menstrual cycle is not, as they would say in Creole, wow, whoa, or any why. And it's not a month. Yes, it's a lunar month. But not a solar month. Not a month like we have in the calendar. It's a 28-day cycle. So basically, I cycle 2 times for the month. Why is there something wrong with me? No, nothing wrong with you. Because the month, some months are 31 days. So if you see your cycle on the first of the month, on the 28th of the month, you're going to see it again. Because you don't have a monthly cycle. You have a what? 28-day cycle. Alright? So you understand that? So right now you can see clearer out of the glass. Alright? So, understanding that you have a 28-day cycle, when does that cycle begin? The cycle begins the first day when you begin to hemorrhage, or when you're going to bleed. That is your day number one. Alright, now, the main reason why a woman goes through that cycle is as a preparation for pregnancy. Alright, so, let's understand that. After the blood, the walls of your womb has broken out, and it comes out, and you're bleeding and you're hemorrhaging. So that means the lining of the womb is actually coming out. After this has happened, and during that process, your special hormone that science is a chemical that's so high. The chemical is so high now that it's making your womb contract. So you say you have cramp. Because that chemical is so high now, and it's making your womb contract just to share the walls of the inside of your womb. So it's breaking it off, and it's coming out. That's why you are bleeding. And you have a little cramp, because the chemical to make your womb cramp, to contract, is up. Right? So a woman will bleed for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, a month. Why? Because the chemical for making her womb contract is up. So she bleeds for a whole month because she has an imbalance in the hormones. Because the function of a physical structure is controlled by hormones. Now we understand that. Okay, so all the blood comes out and you have. So now, when the blood has come out, that wall, is how thin it is? A hormone, estrogen, the female hormone, is responsible for making the inside of the womb of the woman thick and grow. So when the woman has a cycle, and the the walls of the womb are filled, the estrogen level has to increase. And progesterone, which causes that egg to get mature, and the lining of the womb to get thick, to be thickened. Now, if a woman has excessive estrogen, and the estrogen does naturally cause the lining of the womb to get thick, if a woman has too much estrogen, what might happen to her? What will happen? What will happen to the lining of the womb? It will get thicker. So they say, well, you have, it might get so thick because you have too much estrogen. It might get so thick that it gets so thick that the two of them stick together. Then they say you have endometriosis. Right? And because the level is so high, the inside of your womb begins to grow on the outside. Because the chemical is so high, your uterine lining begins to grow on the outside and even sticks onto the walls of your pelvic area and onto that area here right underneath your belly. So you have what they call what? Endometriosis. Right? So your endometrium, which is the inner lining of your womb, is excessively growing. It's growing everywhere. So you have adhesions. So when you have your period, plenty pain. Why? Because the chemical in your body is too high. So it's not about going and cut out the womb, you know, because you have a bone scrape. If you scrape that wall, when you're going to paint it again, you don't have to go and put compound and to make it a bit nice again. So when somebody scrapes inside of you and then put a vacuum and suck it out, you think that's something that's good? Now, that egg here matures and is released on your 14th day. So you have from day one, you're breaking out. Going from day one to day seven, you have the womb start building back on the inside. From day seven to day 14, oh, the inside of the womb is nice and ready. The egg could be released. If you have sexual intercourse and the sperm meets the egg, boom, 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 it goes and goes right into that thick, thick layer of blood to get nourishment. Right? So the woman is pregnant. She's fruitful. Okay. Now, if it is that she is fruitful, the shell that the egg actually comes out of, because remember, the egg itself is in a shell. Right? Called the copper stufum. Where the copper stufum, right? But it's in a shell or a capsule and it releases the egg. So the egg actually comes out, but the shell actually remains. And it remains now and produces a chemical that prevents the woman from having another menstrual cycle. Very important. Until the child has grown, the baby grow enough, a couple of weeks, and starts to develop its what you call own amniotic sac, the bag. Then that shell or the corpus lupum disappears, and the sac begins to produce that same chemical progesterone to prevent you from having a menstrual cycle. So if it is that you have 5, 6, 7 sacs inside of your ovary, what would they be doing? They'd be producing that same chemical. Would you have your period? No. So a woman with polycystic ovarian syndrome has many of these sacs in her ovaries, producing progesterone and making a breast sensitive in the morning like she's pregnant, making her feel like she wants to vomit. She has seen her period for 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, a year. And they say nothing, I said a year could be sad. How long she not see her period? Why? Because of the chemical her body believes that she's pregnant. That's what you call polycystic ovarian syndrome. PCOS. You understand that? Alright, okay. Now, Very important. If she doesn't get pregnant, and the egg goes out on the 28th day, that happens again. And it continues. That's what we call the menstrual cycle of the woman. It's a 28th day cycle. So it's a chemical that's also responsible for making a woman feel, let's say, unhappy or restless. You can't hear your ears right now. You hear it a little. And whenever you close to your cycle, you get what? Very irritable. Why? Because that same chemical that caused you to has also emotionally caused you to become irritable. So there's nothing wrong. So if you know a woman good enough and you know she's coming close to her cycle, and you know what's going on as a man, so you give her space. Yeah. Well, that's things I had to learn with my empress. I had to learn this.